Hi friends, welcome to a short review of a film I saw yesterday here in Copenhagen. In one of the cinemas here in this town, we have so-called 3D Max technology. I'm quite sure that this technology is not new anymore, but when it was presented here in Copenhagen 6-7 years ago, it was presented as the best of the best in new technology, and that should give the viewers a feeling of being present themselves in the place where the film is supposed to happen. And this film is supposed to happen in some kind of future society where there is a foreign civilization, some kind of UFO or hostile civilization out in space trying to invade and conquer the world. This is a classic team, and of course in the end the American hero saves the whole world and saves the American civilization and everything is good. Well, the action is very banal. The authors, they are not very good, to be honest. Will Smith was maybe the only actor I could recognize, but some of the other actors, I'm quite sure they are American used sex symbols too, because the average level of age among the actors were among maybe 25 to 30 years, maybe below that. So the whole world is populated from the president. It was a woman in the beginning and a man in the end, and they were maybe 35 years old. And the heroes that saved the world, they are around 25 years old. Well, everything is very fantastic and, to be honest, very boring. The best thing in the film is the sound. They have a fantastic speaker system in these 3D Max cinemas, so you really can feel the bass level and high notes, so you have a real feeling of being present when it comes to sound. And that is not very pleasant, because the sound is so loud that I wanted to have my earplugs with me, because it was not pleasant to be in the cinema. And the actors, they were maybe good or maybe bad. Actually, if I hadn't read the description of the film in the paper, I wouldn't know what it was about, because it was nothing but futuristic attack UFOs and helicopters and drones and machines and laser machine guns fighting all the time. And it became very boring from maybe minute number 10, and unfortunately this whole film took about 2 hours. There were maybe 10 or 15 viewers in the cinema, and they were all very young people, equipped with gigantic bags of popcorn and bottles of Coca-Cola. So I think that's how you survive a film like this, sitting in your chair and getting a headache from all the noise from the speakers, and eating your 2 liters of popcorn and drinking 1 liter of Coca-Cola. I would say the average BMI level among the viewers was around 35. So there's a reason why young people here in Denmark, they are fat. But this film was, in my opinion, not good. It was also Jeff Goldblum. I know this actor, I've seen him before in other films. He was among the actors here. And I think the longest scene where he's playing anything, it's around 15 seconds, because they are they have cuts all the time from one place to another, and you really don't know where you are, because all places are equal. It is futuristic moon bases and moon stations, and of course everything is placed around the idea of the White House ruling America and America fighting against the evil enemies out in space and saving the whole world. I told you that very banal Hollywood drama idea that is the basic of many, many American films. I was totally confused with this film. What was it about, and how can young people sit for 2 hours and listen to this noise and these absolutely bullshit nonsense showing on the screen? Of course, you always know what time it is, not what time of the day, because it could be any time of the day when you're seeing a film like this, but what historical time it is, because Hollywood films, they always show the American friends and enemies. And nowadays, American want to be friend with France and with China. So the female hero, one of them, there were several, she was a Chinese pilot that helped to save America and save the world. And you also saw in the end scenes where all the evil rockets and fighter planes and planets, they were destroyed by our hero, 22 years old, captain, this or that, before he went out of a black hole and was reunited with his lovely girlfriend. Well, then you see all the evil UFOs and worlds and everything, they are blowing to pieces. Americans, they just love bombs and military, because in the last since the Second World War, even before, there never had bombs in America. They're always bombing other countries. And nowadays they want to unite with France and China, and of course against the Russians, so you saw no Russians at all on the screen, because I'm quite sure that the viewers understood that behind these evil forces in outer space, probably there was some kind of Russian threat, because this is the mentality of American foreign policy. This film was nothing but computer graphic. I believe the actors, they have stood in front of a green screen all the time and trying to play their roles. And after that, they have put all these computer graphic animation behind them using the green screen technique. And then they put on the sound. And I was not impressed at all, not even impressed of the technical level of this film. I was placed in the middle of the cinema, but out in the right side of the cinema. And from there, the sound was okay, but the picture was very bad. Of course, you need to have glasses on to see a film like this. I'll show you the glasses. Here you have the 3D glasses you need to carry to see a film like this. And if you don't use your glasses, you will see a double picture on the screen. So you need to keep on your glasses, then the two pictures will fit together and you will see only one picture, but in 3D. It looks like it is filmed in several levels that are behind each other. like you see in theater, puppet theater, they have several levels on the scene, the foreground, the middle ground, and the background. And this was the same way they had created 3D effect in this film here. I was not impressed. It was not a very sharp picture. The sound was very good, but the acting and the whole idea of this film was so Holly Americanistic and unrealistic that I didn't like it. It looked more like some Hollywood propaganda directed against quite unintelligent young people. And I'm afraid that's exactly what it was. Thank you for listening.